gentlemen, it's the star of our show, Tommy Cooper.
Thank you. Good evening. Ever got time for more? I shall now produce from this empty cloth four live ducks. Oh! I got away again. Look, see that? This one's just the same. Here's a little trick I'd like to show you now. It's a very famous egg and bag trick. Here's the egg, is the bag. My teeth itch. I went to the dentist, he said, my teeth are all right, but my gum's gonna come out. And I said, he looked at me, and I said, I've got a terrible pain just up there. See? And up there it was. So he said, I'll tell you what I do. I said, what's that? Because he spoke to me. And I said, I got a pain up there. He said, well, I'll tell you what, I'll x-ray it. So you get these little tiny x-rays like that, a little small one like that. And you put it up there like that, and you hold it up there like that. And I'm sitting there like that. And they bring this x-ray machine in, see? And it, like there. And it went, just like that. And he took it out and he looked at it and he said, no wonder it hurts. You got a finger poked up there. Egg bag baggy. You know, as I was waiting to go in the scene, the same dentist, and I was sitting reading the magazines, wasn't it awful about that Titanic? Another thing, we're vanishing in front of your very eyes. And you're, oh, my feet are killing me. They are, every night when I'm lying in bed, they get me around the throat like that, trying to strangle. I want you to watch me very, very closely. And if you see any suspicious moves, don't say anything. This egg will vanish in front of your very eyes, and you won't have the slightest clue where it's gone. And yet, on the other hand, I've got four fingers and a thumb. Oh, dear. Hey, I'm just slightest screw where it's gone, haven't you? Hey, where? Under my arm? No. Another one? No, look at that there. This one? No, look at that. Hi, how's that? Thank you. Thank you. And you put your hand in this other bag, and you bring the egg out to a thunderous applause. It's not my night, is it? I've always been unlucky. I had a rocket horse once, and it died. I've got a cigarette lighter that won't go out. So, look at that, I'm leaking. So I went to this doctor, and I said, it hurts me when I do that. He said, well, don't do it. Yeah, I had a meal last night. I ordered everything in French, surprised everybody. It was a Chinese restaurant. And I said to this Chinese waiter, I said, look, this chicken I got here is cold. He said, well, sure, he's been dead 2 weeks. I said, not only that, I said it twice. I said, he's got one leg shorter than the other. He said, what do you want to do, eat it or dance with it? I said, forget the chicken. It's making me ill now. I said, forget the chicken. I said, give me a lobster. So he brought the lobster. I looked at it. I said, just a minute. I said, just a minute, I said. I said, you only got one claw. He's been in a fight. I said, well, give me the winner. A lovely audience, a sitting ovation. And I said, oh, got something in my eye. It's a finger. So I said to this chap, what happened then? So I said, to this Chinese waiter, I said, excuse me, and he said, yeah? Look at that, impressions as well. I said, tell me something. I said, are there any Chinese Jews? He said, I don't know, go find out. So he went and he came back, he said, no. There's only apple juice, pineapple juice, and orange juice. So I said, to this Chinese waiter behind the counter, see, I said, excuse me, and he said, yeah? Could have been the same one. Well, he could have walked around, couldn't he? I said, have you got frog's legs? And he said, yes. I said, well, hot weather kind of get me a cheese sandwich. My boy said to me today, he said, what do you call a gorilla that's got a banana in each ear? And I said, what do you call a gorilla that's got a banana in each ear? He said, anything you like, you can't hear you. The very famous vanishing one. There's a white tip here and a white tip there. Now, the reason for the white tips is to separate the ends from the center. I get worse. Look, it clicks up a hand, look at that. It can't fall down. Got my finger there. A solid one. We'll vanish in front of your very eyes. Here's a quick joke. Oh, yes. There was in the jungle, and there's a hyena. You know, a hyena. And he's talking to this monkey. And he said to this monkey, he said, you see that little passage, that little thing down there, a little narrow. He said, just down there. He said, you see those big clump of trees and bushes? And this monkey said, yes. He said, well, I go home that way every night. He said, I don't have to. But, you know, it's a shortcut for me, I'll go home. He said, but every time I get to that bunch of trees there, he said, this lion jumps out and throws me all over the place. He said, I don't know why he picked on me. All the time he keeps throwing me about, bashing me about. He said, and then he goes. You know, he thinks it's funny, you know what I mean? So, this monkey said, I know what you mean. He said, well, I tell you what, he said, I'll come over here tonight, you know, he said, to protect you. So he said, would you? He said, yes. So they shook hands on it, nothing in writing, just shake it, they shook it. And he started to walk down towards this clump of trees, see? I can't help laughing, I know what's coming next. And he got down to this clump of trees, and he was just going to turn like that, and this lion jumped out and got this hyena and went boom, boom, boom. And this monkey went right up the tree and left him there, looking at him like that. And he was looking at him like that. And all of a sudden, this lion went boom, boom, and left this hyena on his back like that. He may have been like that, no, he's like that. The monkey came down. I was standing beside him. And this hyena's like that. And he looks up to this monkey. He said, "What happened?" He said, "I thought you were going to help me." He said, "Well, I was," he said. "But when I looked down," he said, "you were laughing so much, I thought you were winning." But you know, I'm very soft-hearted, really. I am, honestly. I wouldn't harm a fly. And I never use these fly killers, never. I use this. Instant starch. Doesn't kill them, but they glide out the window like that. Ladies and gentlemen, I was walking up the other night and a man came out from a doorway. He said, "Have you seen a policeman around here?" I said, "No." He said, "Stick him up." A lot of people express their feelings through different ways. Some people express their feelings through a song. Other people express their feelings through poetry. But tonight, I will express my feelings by speaking to you through my trumpet. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Over in glasses.
I should be locked up.
You see this leaf? I saw this little leaf on a tree all on its own. All on its own, it was because its little brother and sisters had been blown away with the wind. So I thought to myself, I'll take that little leaf home. And I put it in a little flower pot on the windowsill with fresh soil. And let the sun gleam on it so that it would grow into a nice big tree, all proud. All on his own. And then I thought, oh, the hell with it. Five hearts, ace of spades, queen of diamonds. But the ace of spades down there, five of hearts down there, and the queen of diamonds has completely vanished. Both sides of the mat, look. What? How's that then? Hey. The other side. Look at that. Here's a pack of cards. Now, I'd like someone here now at random. Mr. Random. Would you think of any card you like in the pack, so don't tell me? Think of any card, sir. No, just think of one, sir. Have you thought of one, sir? Right, now, this is mind over matter. If you don't mind, I don't matter. I put the cards in there, sir. Now this duck! Will take your chosen card from that pack. Now you may have seen a duck do that before. But be fair, blind. What was your card, sir? No, correct. No, no. Second. Empty! 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 Dark in Dr. Livingstone, I presume?
No.
Thank you. Thank you. It gives me great pleasure to name this ship the Sheik of Araby. Dr. Livingstone, I presume?
Yes.
Well, look, they can't read your prescription down at the chemist. Excuse me. Are you Albert Smith, 49 Billabong Avenue, Melbourne, Australia?
Yeah, that's right, Cobber.
Well, your tea's ready. I like to finish right now, I think. What I'm going to do is this.
Water! And, water! I must have water. There it is.
Oh, it's freezing.
Oh, thank you, sir. Oh, I'm much obliged to you, sir. Thank you, sir. Oh, thank you, sir. Hello, Joe. Go on, say hello to Joe. Oh, say hello to Joe.
Who?
Joe, say hello to Joe.
Where?
He's up there in that tree. Go on, say hello to Joe. Go on, say hello to Joe.
All right. Hello.
Hello, say hello. Say hello to Joe.
Hello, Joe.
Is that Joe? What? A drink for old time's sake? Oh, sure, Joe. What, one from a friend? Yeah? Oh, great. Yeah, have a drink with Joe. Yeah. Good health. Cheers, Joe. Say cheers to Joe. Go on, say cheers to Joe.
Cheers to Joe.
Say cheers to Joe.
Cheers, Joe.
What?
Careful, what? They're all over me.
What do you mean I cracked the glass? It was cracked in the first place.
Yes, it was. I saw that. It was. No, it was.
That's how you got there, Joe.
It was cracked. It was cracked.
A gun?
It was cracked.
A gun?
Yes.
Now you put that gun down,
yeah,
Joe.
Put that gun down, Joe.
Put that gun down, Joe.
He's got a gun.
He's got a gun. He's got a gun. Put it down, Joe. Yeah, put that gun down, Joe.
Put it down.
Put that gun down, Joe.
Now you put that.
Put it down, Joe. I know what you're like with guns, Joe.
Go on.
But I've got a gun as well, see?
Well, let it, baby.
I'll let you have it, Joe. I mean it.
Go on.
Right. Take that.
Yes. Glassy eyes, Joe. Look! There's blood all over the place!
What's that? It's the police! Police! Well, they'll never take me alive, I tell you that! They'll never take me! They'll never get me!
Hello, Fred. What's that, Fred? A drink for old time's sake.
Yeah, all right, Fred, yeah.
Half a drink. Cheers, Fred. Cheers. What? What? I cracked your mug. How could you crack a tin mug? Put that gun down, Joe. I know what you like with guns. Put it down, Joe. I'm warning you, Joe. I am. Put it up. I got a knife. I got a knife. I'll let you have it. I will. Take that. And that. And that. I shot him with a knife. Oh, Fred. Fred. Where are you, Fred? Oh, there you are. Oh, sorry, Joe. Don't look at me, Fred, with that one big glassy eye. And look, there's bleed all over the place. I'm getting out of here. They won't take me alive. I'm coming. Oh, I'm coming. They won't take me alive.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to do something now very dramatic for you. I'll write and recite a poem for you. "'Twas New Year's Eve at Joe's pub. A happy mob was there. The bars and tables were crowded, lots of noise filled the air. In the middle of all this gaiety, the door banged open wide. A torn and tattered tramp walked in. Happy New Year, folks, he cried. The crowd just looked at him and laughed, and some began to jeer. But a sailor standing at the bar said, "Ship ahoy, mate, have a beer." "Oh, thank you, son," the tramp replied. "The beer me are through. I'll never touch a drop again, but I'll split a bottle of rum with you." Then up jumped a banker, who happened to be there. Said, "Throw him out," he cried. "He contaminates the air." "Those harsh words, friend," the sailor said. The banker said, "So what?" And Carbo said, "Are you aiming to be shot?" "Are you aiming to be shot?" "It was New Year's Eve, Joe." "The middle one is getting jumping up. The crowd just sort of laughs at me. I won't be a second. Oh, yes. Then up jumped the soldier. I said, "This ain't no time to fight." The sailor said, "You're right." And the banker said, "Well, all right." Then up jumped a woman and stared at the tram. "It's goodness, it's Sam," she cried with fright, and her face went white. "Who's Sam?" a fireman said. The tramp Where's the tram? Oh, yeah. Replied, I'm Sammy Cried, and that painted woman is my promised bride. Lush, don't make me laugh. No, don't make me laugh. The tramp, the farmer said, you cannot wed that horse. Why not, replied the tramp. We never were divorced. It's a lie, the woman shouted. It's the truth, the tramp yelled out. Hold everything. Yes, said the soldier. And the farmer said, ooh.
You can pet us a bit of the pet. It's very hard. I'm gonna cut my head up and just pat it or something. You can cut your head wide open with that.
And the farmer said, I'll kill that pup. Oh, ah, a tough guy, said a pilot. He was standing above. The cowboy hit the fireman, and the fireman hit the floor. He got up straight away, looked at the woman, and said, I was a mug for you to fall. And then he hit her. My gosh, she screamed. Ah. And then the fight was free for all. In rushed a Frenchman, a little schoolboy. I don't even know who that is. Then all of a sudden, they heard a policeman's whistle. They heard a policeman's whistle. They heard a policeman's whistle. Isn't it marvellous, eh? That's all he had to do. And he's wearing makeup as well. And a policeman came in and pissed the whole damn bunch. Come on, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our surprise guest, Frankie Vaughan.
Bevan Brook, where no one else can see. Give me a bench for two, where we can be the king. And I, she's gonna be. If there's anyone and they'd like to try me out, give me the moon, give me the girl, and leave the rest at you and me. Good night.